Sundays. I used to find Sundays pretty scary when I was in college. They were usually consumed by anxiety of what was waiting for me on Monday. But as I've gotten older, when I spend it right, Sundays have become my most valuable day of the week. Spend a Sunday with me in Brooklyn. Let's fuel our day and grab some cafecito. There's this super cute cafe in Brooklyn called Link Street Coffee. Did you know that 50% of the reason I moved to New York City is because of the coffee shops? I'm just kidding. But I did always dream of becoming a regular at my local coffee shop where the barista knows my name and my usual order and we chat about the exciting things happening in our lives. I got a hot latte with oat milk because it's 2021, and I sit and admire each person's impeccable layering ability. New York City is like a real-life Pinterest board. I just need to people watch to get the best outfit inspiration. Okay, but we need to get our steps in, so let's walk to the park. What's interesting is that since living in New York City, not only have my number of steps increased, but so has my speed. But since it's a cozy Sunday, I'll let myself slow down a little bit. You know that song sung by Billie Holiday, then Ella Fitzgerald, then Frank Sinatra, Autumn in New York? It goes, "Autumn in New York, why does it seem so inviting?" They really knew what they're talking about because Autumn in New York is like a movie. It almost feels like I'm transported back to the 1950s where everything seemed so elegant and nostalgic at the same time. My feelings for Sundays changed when I stopped looking at it as a pre-Monday, but as what it is, a day of the week where I don't technically need to show up to work. A concept that I've been trying to implement is protecting my energy. I've realized that protecting my energy isn't just about what I decide not to do, but also what I decide to do. If I spend it really selectively, Sundays can be a huge part in protecting my energy. This Sunday was extra special because it was that perfect combination of sunny and crisp. When the sun is shining, I can look at seasonal depression in the face and be like, can't touch this. I mean, D3 vitamins are great, but nothing fills up your cup like the queen, the sun herself. And yes, I am still drinking my coffee if you're wondering. I think I just love coffee so much that the thought of it being gone is just too sad for me to bear, so I just let it last forever. We're now in Cobble Hill, a quaint part of Brooklyn. If I really want to feel like the main character of this make-believe novel that is my life, then I'll go to any bookstore. It makes me feel like that mysterious girl who no one knows but everyone wants to know about. You know, I bought a Kindle last year, but even being the UX designer that I am, who works on digital experiences, I have to say, you don't get that same feeling of wonder that you get getting lost in all your options in a bookstore. So both 2021 and my Sunday are coming to a close, so I hope spending some time with me filled up your cup a little bit. I am heading home, and it feels pretty great to not have let the thought of Monday ruin my Sunday. But no matter what, both Monday and 2022 are gonna come, so we might as well remain present and unbothered like this very distinguished gentleman of an Italian greyhound. See you later.